team with defensively.
England poses a different challenge, and I remember leading up to the game reflecting on how they took Australia apart in the World Cup, you know, at the breakdown, at the scrum, in the tight phases. And, you know, it was crucial we went to that area.
Knowing that if you win this, then suddenly you're into a semi-final scenario where, you know, it's really in your own hands.
England were so good defensively that day that they just couldn't be penetrated. Their midfield defence was like a brick wall. It pushed up hard. They took the space away.
Sometimes defences are so stoic and so up for games, it is difficult to break them down, and we had to make sure that we kept our own defence solid.
Les Kiss doesn't give much away in his interviews about what his defensive system is about, but from what I understand, he allows what he calls shooters. So an individual, often Brian O'Driscoll, can make this decision to leave the line and envelop the ball carrier, and from which they might get a turnover. And they did that several times. They were very good at winning turnover at the breakdown, probably the best of any team in the Six Nations.
That game was a bit of a blur to me. Dricko, I think, got a bit of a hiding, didn't he?
I had a bad headache for a good part of the second half. But it was another one of those very, very physical games.
Fantastic seminal moment when they go down the left and O'Driscoll is taken out and he's getting treatment, and Ireland have a penalty and they could go for the posts. But the senior lieutenants, O'Gara and O'Connell, and it was a very much collective leadership in this team, and you need that kind of experience, they took it upon themselves to go to the corner.
And O'Gara has declined the three. And they go for the corner in the crowd. And we all know...
It was a real game where, you know, we needed a real leader and someone to, you know, to grab the game by the scruff of the neck.
It took like three late tackles in a row, but he still kept standing up.
His try was probably the memory that stood out most for me. It was, we had to work bloody hard for that try.
Sees what's up next. It's O'Driscoll! Brian O'Driscoll!
It took a lot of guts for him, you know, to get over the line.
He's just so low, like, it's incredible.
You know, what you want from a captain is step up to the mark when it's called for, his ability to read the game and just put his body on the line.
Delivered today by his extraordinary courage and willingness to put his body on the line for his country was quite incredible. An extraordinary example of what Irish fortitude, courage and sheer bloody-mindedness can do for this country.